All right, howdy guys, this is T3EX Havoc hitting you up not so live again with a good gameplay on Dome. And today I decided to guest star my friend Mayhem simply because this game was titled Mayhem Would Have Done Better. And the only reason why I named it that was because Mayhem always seems to do better than me, and I wanted to test his luck and see if he could do better than this game. So, here he is.
Yeah, what's up, guys? I remember I just the guys were talking to me like last night, like just a lot of different guys were talking about, Havoc put up a new thing on his file share that was just really impressive, and I took a look on it, and it's just it's pretty good, which is a shocker because he's not always too hot. But I mean, this was an insane amount of kills that I'd seen in like a post match, and I haven't gotten this many myself.
This was definitely new for me. I've never seen anyone actually drop any more kills than I've ever done in this game, in all honesty. But there are people out there. But I guess today we were gonna talk about my setup and what I was using, and the relatively how basic it was. And
I was real shocked about, like, I mean, you got this PP90 here. A lot of people know the power of this gun, but if you know how to use it, combined with just like the simple things like this tag insert, he would just spawn on top of kids, and they just get wrecked in the face. I know this was rapid fire, and it's just like it's hard to stop that, you're pretty much gonna get torn apart by whoever uses that.
Yeah, there's a lot of times where I would just end up spraying, but that's simply because I just didn't need to zoom in. Like, the kill happens so fast that it's not even worth it.
Yeah, he had his perks. He was rocking sleight of hand and quick draw, and of course steady aim, which always helps
That's
that
a rapid
spraying.
fire there, spray. But yeah, it was great.
I really like the placement of his tag inserts. Like they're kind of random and out there at times, but they always seem to work out. And like, he kept telling me it was just a way of getting quicker to where he wanted to be. And in all honesty, it works out that way. If you know how to use it properly, it's gonna get you to a place a lot faster than, just a regular spawn.
Yeah, that's where I wasn't necessarily placing them smart. And actually, at one point in the video, I actually placed one. Sorry, I actually placed one out in the wide open while there's a Reaper up in the air, and that's simply just to get closer to the next move. And every time I spawn, I have that next 5 seconds before the Reaper kills me to move up to the next spot. And the tag inserts are great because you might not think like being spawned somewhere would be that nice, but when you actually think about it, you're just getting that much closer and you're cutting that much time from running from your spawn to where you want to be. And that's what saved me so much time and allowed me to get so many kills.
Yeah, I mean, those few seconds are definitely gonna, add up, and it's gonna give you the jump on those guys. And if smart kids would start realizing, yeah, that there's some kid using a tactical insurgent and stuff, but like other ones just don't catch on. And you see, like here, he can just they're spawning inside a dome. He's killing them as they come out. He's putting the push on this A domination site, and he's getting these kills over and over again. And these kids don't even know what's happening. They're trying to take the air support out of the sky that he's been putting up. And these last 5 seconds, he just annihilates these people, and finally some guy destroyed his tactical insertion. Like I just, that's the first one I've seen that's been destroyed, but the kids are like finally catching on, but he just kept wrecking face.
Yeah, this game was really fun because I don't know if it was just the kids or what, but they just weren't catching on, and I was just simply moving around with the tag inserts, moving up to the next base, getting kill feeds. Like, if I died, I had the tag insert, I was right where I wanted to be right after that, and it just worked out perfectly. And we actually know a guy on the top of one of the top of the leaderboards for domination, and he would only run around with a striker and tag inserts.
It was really insane. I didn't know I mean, I didn't prefer the whole striker method, but I mean, technically, like inserting, that's where it's at. If you can do it right, you got a definite heads up on these people.
Yeah, I decided to take his basic class and tweak it up a little bit more my style, and I pretty much used what he would use, but I used a PP90 because I knew that was kind of it's a great gun to use. And with the rapid fire being that close, plus I get a little extra range because it's an SMG and I'm shooting bullets, not slugs, I figured I could probably do a little bit better. And that's where I think the SMG also helped, was running running around faster too. So I was constantly moving throughout the map.
I really like how he's using his simple kill streaks. I think that was my favorite part. I was like, man, what kill streaks were you using? Because like, I know if I put up a high amount, I'm using like Reaper and like, you know, maybe a tag chopper or like Pavlo or something stupid like that. But like, he had the basic kill streaks, and I think that's what bummed me out the most was that, you know, it was just a lot of doing work and a lot of kids not taking down air support that often. And you could just see it was constantly boning them, and it was real bad on their part. And he was dropping, you know, predator missiles all over the place. And those triple kills are just going to, you know, add up to the overmounting amount of final kills you're going to have. And it was just really crazy.
Yeah, the predator missile is great, especially in domination, because when people are capping a base, you just say, okay, I'm just going to pull out the predator missile, and I'm going to drop it down on that base, and I'm going to get like probably a double or triple every time. And that, if I hadn't ruined my kill streak or anything, I'm going to get the next kill streak.
Mm-hmm.
And yeah, my kill streaks were simple: the UAV for team play and then the helicopter.
Yeah. And these kids, you know, they're not really paying attention. You see, he was pushing through mid way earlier, and then, you know, it was kind of stuffed full of kids. He just tactically started on the other side of that dome, you know, pushed over on this side, and he caught him on their weak side. And you see him just picking up kill after kill, and what I love is he's taking the base at the same time. Like, you've seen him cap multiple bases over this, and it's not him chilling in some corner. It's him, you know, running around trying to get these points. And he puts up a mad amount of points.
Yeah, at the end, I end up dropping around 7,000 points, and that was because of the combination of capping the bases and kills. You know, if I was only capping the kill, getting kills, I would have ended up with sufficiently less. And that's where this gameplay style with attack inserts is superior over camping.
I think so. I like this again. You know, you see, on Dome, I mean, there's only so many things that can happen, but, you know, he does a good way of just being on top of it. You know, they're spawning in Dome, they're coming out, and he's able to cap that base, go over them. And then, like, look at this. Easy triple. Like,
next kill streak, please.
It's just calling in. No, you can't have air support. It's too crowded. It's just thing after thing, and he's constantly cycling up. You know, he constantly had something next to put in the air to drop down on them. They're having a hard time. He kept pushing them out of their spawn. They're feeling uncomfortable. And while his team's spawning on one side, he just tactically started on the other. And it was just back and forth.
Yeah. I've definitely noticed, after watching this gameplay a couple times, it seems like every time I'd cap a base, they'd be capping another one. And that's partially due to my opponents, is that I could just move on to the next flag and get more and more points.
Mm-hmm.
So it's hard to come across that.
I like that little part right there. You're trying to put a tag insert.
Yeah,
I hate caught. When that happens. I like, that's the worst, but...
That's where quick draw was really useful in this class. I wasn't throwing as many grenades as I wanted to, but it was definitely helping me put down the tags.
Look, I mean, right there, you just saw a great display. You know, he killed one kid off the base, technically inserted around the corner. The guy might have killed him, but the guy wasn't ready. You know, he was able to spawn again right on top of there, took it, killed the kid, got their base, called it a day. And it's just...
Yeah, this is the mention. I was running towards the kid with the Reaper, and I do end up, like, finding him right there in the corner. And so I just tagged insert right on the middle. In case I died, I would be that much closer to him.
And it's just a well played, you know, and then he breached right up inside B base and just kept doing work. I mean, I've watched this maybe like once before fully, but like, I just keep seeing this, and it's just really funny to watch all this.
Well, that's it. I hope you guys enjoyed watching. This is Havoc and
Mayhem
hitting you up. So, see you guys later.